Before there was Viagra, there was oysters. Stay tuned. So you want a really romantic dinner with maybe some action after, whether you're married or single. Candles, soft music, you set the scene. You don't want a heavy dinner because that's not going to be very romantic 30 to 60 minutes after you eat it. Nobody wants to feel like they have a rock in their stomach when they're getting romantic. But did you know that there are certain foods that are good for sex, good for male potency, good to stir the female sex drive? There's actually foods that are good for that. One of those things is oysters. Before there was Viagra, there was oysters. It's not just a folk tale. Now, there's not a lot of, what do they say, double-blind studies and clinical studies on the aphrodisiac properties of oysters. But there's a ton of anecdotal evidence that says oysters are good for your sex life, for better sex and more sex. So think about that. We're going to go through some oysters tonight. And I'm reading this right now. It's not the slippery feel or the taste of oysters that make them a sexy superfood. Although eating an oyster is kind of like eating something else, if you know what I'm talking about. It's the zinc that the oysters are loaded with. And that zinc, it's a mineral that helps the body produce testosterone, which is a hormone that is critical in regulating a woman and man's libido or sex drive, and also sexual function. Those are two different things. You can have a great sex drive with no sexual ability. Eating oysters can give you the drive and the ability, can get you all dressed up and somewhere to go. Research suggests that zinc can improve sperm count and swimming ability and increase sexual potency in men. Say no more. For women, zinc may help the ovaries, source of estrogen, progesterone, and some testosterone. Stay healthy, keeping you primed for action. So let's talk about some oysters real quick. I went out and bought some oysters for Christmas Eve. I walked in the door with oysters, and you know I have a female roommate. She saw me take the oysters out, and one of the first things she said to me was, "What, do you have a date tonight?" All right, I didn't say a thing. She saw the oysters and said, "What, do you got a date?" So I thought that was kind of funny. But here's an oyster. I'm going to show you how to open up an oyster in just a minute. But I have a bunch of oysters right here, and I'm going to show them to you. They're in this bowl. Can you see them? I've already got them shucked. When you open up oysters, it's called shucking the oyster. Some oysters are very salty. Some are very sweet. Literally, they taste like they have sugar on them. Sometimes you can taste the ocean in them. Depending on where they are cultivated, it gives them different flavors. The different things you can do with oysters are you can put lemon on them, little lemon wedge, like that. You can put a little sriracha on them, and I'm talking like a drop, all right? A drop. One drop. Come on, sriracha, where are you? Okay, there's one drop. You can put vinegar on them, and I'm talking just one drop. What it does, it increases the acidity. So there's, hold on, one drop. I'm getting psyched just thinking about these. Or you can put cocktail sauce in them. And I'm just going to put a little bit on here. Little bit. Just a little bit. You don't want to overpower because really the flavor of oysters is quite amazing. You eat them by slurping them. This right here is an oyster that's opened. It might look gross to some. It's probably going to drip. Let me show you. You open it up. You scrape the flesh. You loosen it up on the bottom. And then you slurp it. For those of you who've never had oysters, watch the technique. Got a little brother shell. Ah, sweet, not fishy. Mmm. Wow. Wow. I have 6 different kinds of oysters here. Now I'm going to be all dressed up and nowhere to go. I might have to meet the saltress after. Here's one now. This one's got a little sriracha on it. Look at that. See that? I just spilled it. Part of it is the juice. Oysters are funky. If you think about like all the analogies and metaphors of eating oysters, it is almost kind of sexual in a sense for men and women. If you're not a seafood person, you're probably not going to like these at all. If you're a sex person, that didn't come across right, did it? A sex person. If you're a person that enjoys sex, healthy, normal sex, oysters are going to be good for you, whether you're male or female. Let's try this one here. It's got a lot of the juice in it. And again, the metaphors are very similar to the real thing. Wow. Holy cow. Oh my gosh. Quite incredible. And I got a little bit of sriracha in my mouth. Hold on a second. A little too much. That's what I say, just a drop. Cooling my mouth off now. All right, so I'm going to show you how to open an oyster. I get my oysters at Whole Foods Market right near me. This is an oyster. This is what it looks like. Ugly. It almost looks like just like a rock, doesn't it? And I hold it with a cloth. And I put it on, let's see, can you see this now? I put it like this, against a cutting board. And then I take this is an oyster shucking knife. If you use a regular knife, you will break the tip off. Let's get real. All right. That's all this is. It's not a sharp blade, but it is a sharp point and it's curved. Let me see. Can you see that? So it can pry. You always go into the muscle of the oyster right there. If you're not skilled at this, or if you haven't done it before, you can really hurt yourself. So I pray that I'm not going to hurt myself on this, although I have shucked many oysters in my lifetime. I like holding them with a towel because it gives you a grip and it kind of protects your fingers because you don't want this slipping and going into your hand. So I'm going to go like this, pry, and then twist. Watch. Now watch. Twist, watch, twist, and you kind of pop it open. Go a little further down, twist, pop. Then you can just pry this right off with a little bit of help of the knife. Watch. Like that. Now, there's some of that muscle that held the shells together. You want to scrape that. And this is what we have. I'm just going to spill that lovely juice all over the place. Now, it's being held by another muscle on the bottom. So I'm going to scrape it off of this, off the bottom. And you'll know, because you'll get a little bit of resistance. I'm going to scrape that off. I was talking to my dad today. We were talking about oysters, man. He was like, man, now I got to get some oysters. It's so funny. You can put a drop of whiskey, a drop of brandy, a drop of rum. Whiskey would be good because a lot of whiskeys are very smoky. So a little smoky flavor with the oyster would be incredible. Now, I didn't put anything on this. I just shucked it. Now I'm going to eat it. Make sure it's loose so it's not dripping down my chin, which I'm not opposed to in case it does happen. So good. That one was very salty. I feel like I have a mouthful of salt. It's incredible. Mmm. And the flavor is just, it's clean. It's cleaner than fish. It's cleaner. There's nothing fishy about an oyster. And the smell, literally, do you ever go to the ocean and you just kind of like smell the ocean mist? That's what an oyster smells like to me. Now, a great thing to drink when you have oysters is white wine. Hold on a second. All right, so here we go. I'm going to pour some Pinot Grigio. Put this over here. Let me just clean up the palate a little bit. I like my white wines cold. That's beautiful. Right, so let's try the oyster with the cocktail sauce. And I put this on a bed of ice, because obviously seafood, you want to keep it fresh. Oh, heavenly. Absolutely heavenly. Honestly, it really is. So good. Well, that's wonderful. I'm going to finish these off with a little bit of Pinot Grigio, and I'm going to put some vinegar on some and squeeze a little bit of lemon juice. But here's to you, guys. If you have any issues, just Google foods that get you in the mood or foods that boost libido. Take my word for it. If you eat those foods, you're not going to have an issue at all. If there's nothing medically wrong with you. Cheers, my brothers and sisters. Enjoy.